Tesla asking shareholders to vote again on Elon Musk's $56 billion pay package that was struck down by a Delaware judge in January. Tesla also hoping to move the company's incorporation from Delaware to Texas. And joining us right now is Charles Elson. He is founding director of the Weinberg Center at the University of Delaware. Good morning to you. We had a pretty fiery debate with Ann Lipton from Tulane University yesterday about exactly what may or may not happen as a result of this, and effectively whether shareholders, if they did vote, in fact, again now to put this plan back in place, that would be a legal thing to do. She seemed to suggest she thought it was not. What do you think?
With her on that one. I mean, look, they can vote on it, but the judge in the opinion pretty clearly says not only was the process bad, but the result that the equity comp that they designed was effectively a gift to Mr. Musk, that there was no value received. Now, companies can give things away, money away, without corporate purpose, but everyone's got to agree to it. You've got to get every shareholder, and that's not going to happen here. I mean, the idea is that having a shareholder vote of disinterested shareholders is certainly helpful in establishing something was fair. But here, she's determined that it wasn't, and that's the issue. You have to really rethink the whole package itself. So, yeah, they can vote. There'll be issues on how much was disclosed. Did they tell them everything? I'm sure that will be something the SEC will comment on. But ultimately, she found it was unfair.
This is the piece that I don't understand. The way I read the decision, and maybe we're reading different decisions, I understand that she did seem to think it was wasteful, but I don't believe that the wasteful element of it, if you will, was part of her quote-unquote decision, or frankly shouldn't have been. I thought what she was discussing was simply the disclosure issue, which was that she did not feel that the disclosure was proper as it related to the independence of the board and what she described as a deeply flawed process to get to that number. And effectively, by stapling that decision to this proxy, shareholders can now read her decision. They can see all of the terrible things, if you believe that they're terrible, and I'm not sure they are, but if you believe they're terrible, you can read everything, you know, everything that happened. And if you still voted in favor of this plan, why would that be a problem?
Well, no, I don't think this is a waste case. In fact, I think the lower court, I mean, my previous judge said, no, this wasn't a waste case. What this really is a conflict of interest case. There are a lot of ways to approach compensation. The fact that she ordered rescission, not a revote, but rescission, and the fact, I believe it was on page 173, that she actually says that this equity wasn't incentive to him. It was way beyond, he had enough. In fact, I filed an amicus, and that was in the amicus, which she cited. So, yeah, no, she definitely said, no, this isn't proper, and she rescinded it. That's the key to this opinion. I mean, the process was awful. There's a lot of awful processes, but the fact that she said awful process results in something that I find unfair. Now, if let's say she said, okay, bad process, but this still is still okay, shareholders approved it, that'd be one thing. But she said the result was unfair. And the unfairness is not necessarily the result of the negotiation. It was result, effectively, of what Mr. Musk asked for. And she said,
but Charles, let me ask you this then. Let me flip this whole thing around.
Yeah.
You are the board of the company and you're the shareholder of the company today. Today, you are the owner of you are the shareholder of this company. Okay?
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
Elon Musk has been promised or thinks he's been promised a certain deal that he made in 2018, right? Let's just put ourselves in his shoes for a second, okay? He believes he made a deal, and then not only does he think he made the deal, he thinks that he hit all of the metrics of said deal. Now, you can decide that you believe that there was a conflict and all of that, but that's in his head, okay?
Yep.
He has not been paid, by the way. So I think at some point, forgetting about a gift, some form of compensation you would think would be due to him. It sounds like the judge would like to pay him nothing, but that doesn't make any sense.
No.
You also need to, I assume, if you want Elon Musk to continue to work at Tesla or to focus on Tesla, given that he is somebody that has other opportunities in the SpaceX and the Boring Company and Neuralink and all sorts of other things, he's an unusual character, and one of the great entrepreneurs of our time. if you wanted him to stay, and maybe you can argue, obviously, that he's continued to be disincentivized to stay because he already has this bigger stake, what do you do as a shareholder?
I think that no one, frankly, can hold you over a barrel. Frankly, you know, if someone says, unless you give me X, I'll blow myself up. At some point, you're going to have to say enough. Look, he had 20% of the company then. That's huge. Jeff Bezos, as I recall, he took like a dollar a year. I mean, given your stake as the entrepreneur, the real what you get out of it is the appreciation of what you invested to begin with, which was huge. And to give him all this much more, I think, was wrong. That's what she found. It didn't make any sense.
But ultimately, should judges be deciding this?
Should judges be deciding the amount of money
that's and the metrics with which compensation should be paid? Is that the role of a judge? I believe the role of the judge should be around the disclosure issues. If it's not fair to shareholders and they're not given the appropriate information, I could arguably buy into that. The idea that we're now going to let judges set what is fair, I mean, how do you feel about that?
This is where the opinion was very unusual. This hadn't happened before. But at some point, you have to say that something is so far out of bounds, which, in fact, it goes beyond reality. The fact is, really, why did...
But it only went beyond reality because he went beyond reality, Charles.
Right.
That's the piece of this. If he hadn't hit the numbers, we wouldn't be having this conversation. He went so far beyond reality. We all sat here in 2018 and said, this is absolutely bonkers. The chances of him ever hitting these numbers just is beyond the pale. And yet then he did it. And I don't mean
to... And where is the stock now? It's down quite a bit, as you know, because the reality wasn't necessarily what people thought it was. Yes.
But here's the piece of it, Charles. He's on the same ride with them. Because he's not allowed to sell the shares for another 5 years, even if he gets them tomorrow.
He sold a lot of shares to buy Tesla. He's taking
No. Hold on, Charles. The shares that he sold were shares that were granted to him prior to 2018. He has not touched the shares that were granted to him, or and in this case, they weren't really granted to him. They were put in place in this compensation package in 2018. Right. So, you know, when people say he sold previous shares, that has nothing to do with this conversation at all.
Well, it does because it suggests that he thinks his money was probably better somewhere else rather than in Tesla, which suggests that the Tesla growth of Tesla wasn't going to be exactly as people seem to think because he took his assets and put it into another place, a la X, where he thought...
Do you believe every time a CEO sells shares that is a sign of what they think of the company? In some cases, in this case, he wanted to buy something, and he wanted to use the money. I actually recently talked to a CEO who... It was actually very interesting. I was talking to a CEO who sold some shares. And I said, is this a sign about the company? And the CEO said, go look at how much money I get paid in cash every year. And I went to look. They got paid $250,000 in cash. And they said, I've got bills. Like the CEO looked at me and said, I got bills to pay. I think Elon Musk had bills to pay.
Well, sending a kid to college, putting a new thing on the house, getting a boat. But how many billions of dollars? I mean,
it's a digital boat. And unfortunately, the boat has holes in the boat because he's lost money on that, too.